Hi guys, Paul from UltimateFatBurner.com here, and today I'm going to tell you three things you need to know about creatine ethyl ester. And if you stick around to the end of the video, I will give you a final verdict on whether this supplement is worth your hard-earned cash or not. I'll be right back at you in just a couple of seconds. Stick around, don't you dare go anywhere. All right, you're still here. That's cool. Thanks very much. All right, before we dig into this, there's a link to our full article on creatine ethyl ester in the description below this video. If you want to get more details as well as review the links to the clinical data I reference here and so on. Okay, so just a tiny bit of background on creatine ethyl ester. It's a form of creatine that's advertised as being extremely soluble, which results in greater absorption, increased bioavailability and stability, and of course, it's supposed to be more effective too. Now, if you want to know a little more about the science behind creatine ethyl ester, like how it differs from regular creatine at a molecular level and so on, then check out the article below. I'm going to leave it out of this video just so I won't bore the living shit out of you and to keep this video at a manageable length. So with that out of the way, here are the three things that you need to know, you absolutely need to know about creatine ethyl ester, which I'm going to start calling CEE for short. Number one, despite the claims that CEE is a vastly superior form of creatine, there isn't one shred of evidence in the form of a published clinical trial that supports the conclusion, at least not one that I could find. Its claims seem to be based 100% on advertising and marketing hype. Yeah, no kidding. Number two, this is not a new form of creatine. We first reviewed CEE back in 2009, and nothing has changed since then to affect the conclusion. So, why the increased interest in CEE now? Well, supplements like this often go through sales cycles, and now there's a whole new audience for whom CEE is completely new and unheard of, and this audience is susceptible to claims of it being a superior product. In other words, call me a skeptical bastard, but there's money to be made selling this stuff again, and obviously few genuine real options for the supplement industry to get behind instead. Number three, while there's no clinical data to support the claims of it being more effective, there is clinical data to show that creatine ethyl ester degrades much quicker than creatine monohydrate in the gastrointestinal tract. In other words, it's less effective. More of it is being converted into the waste product creatinine long before it reaches the bloodstream. So what's the bottom line? Is creatine ethyl ester a good alternative to creatine monohydrate? Are we giving this a thumbs up or a thumbs down? It's getting a big thumbs down, big time. My recommendation, don't get caught up in the hype. Stick with what's proven. A German-sourced, micronized creatine monohydrate is all you need. All right, guys, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please do give us a thumbs up. We'd really appreciate that. If you've used creatine ethyl ester, leave a comment below and let us know what you thought. Love to hear your comments, as would our viewers. And of course, if you haven't subscribed to this channel yet, I have to ask you, what are you waiting for? It would be awesome if you joined us. YouTube will send you a notification whenever we post new content, so you never miss anything. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you real soon.